Hi friends, so before I get into the video, I want to talk. So let's just talk first. So for me, this Friday video is my only constant during the lockdown phase. And in India, we are about to finish with our lockdown 3.0, but we know it will also be the start of lockdown 4. So I just want to say this to all of you that stay calm, be patient, and it's okay even if we have to step into the lockdown phase 4, because it's important to combat coronavirus, right? So yeah, so just stay at home, stay safe, and cheer yourself up. That's really important. And you can watch our Q&A videos that we post every Friday. Now, if you may ask, what about these Friday videos, then let me tell you that I really like doing these Friday videos because it's kind of interactive sessions. You guys ask me tech-related questions and I come up with some solutions or maybe suggestions. So if you have any more questions, you can always ask your question on this video. Like put your question in the comment section of this video down below. Use the hashtag #LetsGetTechie and I'll take your question next Friday in the next video. I read the comments that you guys posted on my previous videos, and some of you said that, you know, I'm not taking up your question, and you guys were really annoyed with me. But let me say that I'm really sorry if that has happened. It's not intentional at all. So in case I miss out on your question, you can always ask it again on my new video. So do it if you think I've still not answered your question in this video, so you can always comment. Now let's begin. Question number one. Titan ANS has written, my 10th exam got over. Now I want to take a phone. My budget is around 20k. Please suggest me my first phone. To have a first phone is really a special feeling. I remember that my father bought me Moto G. Yes, just Moto G. 4.5 inches, too compact. I still remember that phone. So, Titan, if you also a thirst for a compact device, then consider Realme X2. It won't be as compact as Moto G though. But otherwise, if size isn't a problem, then you can also go for Poco X2. Next question. Should I go for Poco X2 or wait for Poco F2 after lockdown? What should be the expected price of F2? Okay, so we don't know anything about Poco F2 yet, and there is nothing out as hearsay as well. So if you want a new smartphone, the sensible choice is to go and buy Poco X2. Next question. Kirti Bateriwala. The previous question was asked by Saif Khan. I'm sorry, I missed out on your name. Next question is from Kirti Bateriwala and she has written, I am in 10th standard. Wow, students are asking me questions now. I like it. And for online studies, I want a new phone. So please suggest me any phone between 9 to 10,000 budget. Okay, Kirti, Realme 5i is a really good choice because that phone will give you 4GB of RAM paired with 64GB of internal storage, which is enough for your work and, you know, school files. So yes, and at rupees 10,000. So go ahead. Next question is from Saurabh Kale and he says, which is better to buy after lockdown, OnePlus 8 or ROG Phone 2? OnePlus 8, sir, because ROG 2 gives you a 120Hz display, but it's designed as a gaming phone. So if you want a more practical smartphone for daily usage, then I would say OnePlus 8. Ajay Thakur writes, iPhone SE 2020 versus iPhone XR versus OnePlus 8. My budget is 48,000. Which one I should buy? Please suggest. OnePlus 8 if you want an Android device. Go ahead with iPhone XR if you want an iPhone. Next question. Amit Kumar Baranwal has written, can you suggest a good camera phone for video recording in 20k to 30k budget? Okay. Amit, iPhones are extremely good when it comes to video recording, and they also come with built-in microphone as well. Like, they are pretty decent. So I would suggest that extend your budget by say 10,000 rupees and buy yourself the latest iPhone SE 2020. I'm coming to the point. Budget can really be an issue. So in that case, I would say catch up with local retailers and see if you can buy the iPhone 7. That will solve your problem. Next question. Please, Nitesh Gom asked me, please suggest a good DSLR under 20K. Okay. At rupees 20,000, Nitesh, you can buy an impressive digital point and shoot camera, but getting a DSLR is quite tricky. So anyway, you have to extend your budget to 4,000 to 5,000 rupees. That way you can grab a good deal on Canon 1200D camera. Next question. Manjula Saraf has asked, why Google phones have lagged in capturing the premium phone market? Please do answer. I'm looking forward to buy one. Google has always wanted its Pixel smartphones to be the blueprint of what Android phones should look like. And the entire focus has always been on the cameras. But most consumers, especially Indians, they look beyond cameras and a clean user interface. I mean, they want high-end specifications, vibrant display, and say fast charging system and longer battery life. And most importantly, resale value that, you know, others like Apple and OnePlus and maybe Samsung do well with and not Google. So yeah, Pixel is for a niche market that doesn't exist in India. I mean, for example, what would you choose? A Pixel 3a XL or OnePlus 8? I would choose OnePlus for its, you know, wholesome device. So yeah, Pixel 3a is a great device, but then it offers amazing cameras and that's it. It doesn't feel special. So that's the thing with Pixel phones. Next question. That was a nice question. Thank you, Manjula, for asking. Aditya Dangi writes, hi Pavni. Hello. I currently use a OnePlus 3T since 2016 and looking to upgrade to a phone which is going to last me 3-4 years. Looking for good performance and aesthetics, not bothered about camera or battery. What would be your suggestion in 30K to 40K range? Okay. Go ahead with OnePlus 8, Aditya. With that phone, you get 865 chipset that enables 5G network. So with Snapdragon 865, you get the fast performance. That's what you need. And with 5G network, that guarantees you that your phone will run smoothly for next 3-4 years. And if you want it or not, but OnePlus 8 also gives you an amazing set of cameras. So bonus point. Go ahead with OnePlus 8. Now guys, I'm taking the very last question of today's Q&A video and it's from The Next Level. He is telling his name also. My name is Ritwik Jonathan. My question to you is, what do you think will be the upgraded features of the upcoming OnePlus 8T Pro other than Qualcomm Snapdragon 865 Plus processor, UFS 3.1 storage and 65W warp charge? Okay, there will be Snapdragon 865 and not some 865 Plus. You can also expect improved wireless charging system and more megapixels. Thank you for asking that question. If you like this video, do not forget to give it a big fat thumbs up. Share this video with your friends and subscribe to our channel India Today Tech if you haven't. And stay tuned. Cheer up. Stay home. Stay safe.